some students, the application to higher education involves an additional stage, an interview. This will normally only affect those who are applying for very competitive and popular institutions, a vocational course that leads into a direct profession, or a course that requires a specific skill set, such as music or arts-based subjects. If you know you have to attend an interview, it is important that you don't panic. Instead, spend some time planning for the day. Review your application and research your chosen institution to ensure that everything runs as smoothly as possible. Your interview should be viewed as an extension of your UCAS form. It is an opportunity for you to expand on the information that you've included within your personal statement and for you to further demonstrate your commitment to your subject area. Some students find that a strong performance at interview can lead to a reduced offer or act as a lifeline on results day should they not receive the initial grades that they were hoping for. Therefore, making sure that you represent yourself in the best possible way is key. Before you attend the interview, there are several things that you can do to prepare. Firstly, establishing all of your travel arrangements. You might be familiar with the route to a campus, but locating the building and room that you will be in could take some time. Leave plenty of time for travelling, just in case of roadworks and delays in public transport. And make sure you have the contact details of the interview organiser, in case you need to ring and advise them that you'll be late. It's also worth revising your personal statement and reminding yourself of its content. Some interviewers may base initial questions on this. So for example, if you've mentioned that you've completed the Duke of Edinburgh Award, they might ask you what additional skills you have gained from this activity. The interviewer is likely to ask you about your further education choices, what you enjoy, and how they've helped you to develop as a student. They may also ask you why you've chosen to apply to this course and this particular institution. So researching the university in advance, having an understanding of the modules included in that particular programme, and knowing what attracts you to them is a real benefit. If you are applying for a vocational course, such as teaching, nursing or physiotherapy, then a thorough and accurate understanding of what that job will entail will demonstrate both a commitment and a passion for it. During your interview, it's important that you try and relax and be yourself. Remember to smile and make eye contact with the others in the room. And don't be afraid to take a few moments to consider your reply to any questions before you begin to answer them. Interviewers will be looking for engaged students, so having some of your own questions relating to the course or the university is a really good way of showing this. Some students are asked to bring samples of their work to show, and others may still wish to, even if they're not asked to. In both cases, make sure this is clearly labelled with your name and, where appropriate, laid out in a clear manner to be looked through. If you have letters of recommendation or certificates that you would like to share, then you may choose to present these in a document wallet or folder. Once your interview is over, the most important thing for you to do is relax and try not to overanalyse your answers. You can't change them now. Once you've had a drink and something to eat, you might want to make some notes on what you felt went well and any areas that you think could have been improved on further. These can then be used almost as a revision tool for any future interviews. And don't be afraid to contact universities for feedback. Whether it's good or bad, it can be vital to shaping your interview technique as a whole.